Hello guys, welcome to my first video of class 9th and 10th ICSE computer subject. So in my first video, I will discuss about object-oriented programming. What is object-oriented programming? So let's start without wasting any further time. So what is object-oriented programming? OOPS. In short, we can say OOPS. So OOPS basically is an implemented language which is using objects with data and code. So let's see what is written here. The programming concept which is implemented using an object is known as object-oriented programming. It is talking about POP, another that one. We have not to study here. I will discuss on further videos. In procedure-oriented programming, the control movement from one action to another, most of the functions share global data and that moves freely around the system from function to function. OOPS does not allow data to flow freely from one function to another. So what basically is saying here that object-oriented programming is very strict in considering data, means it does not allow data to flow from one function to another function. It stores only in one function. Only that member method can access their particular data. In this system, the complete problem is decomposed into number of entities called objects. So basic unit of object-oriented programming is object. And each object includes set of data items and least related function and applicable only within the function associated with that object. So what basically here, what I've said before, that it is only applicable with that particular object. That function can be only associated with that particular object. No other can access. So one function cannot flow from another function. It can only access within that object. The resident data can never be handled by external functions. In this way, the data can be protected and secured from being hampered by external sources, and this allows OOP feature to be a powerful tool for programming. So now basically in class 9th and 10th there is a Java programming. So in Java programming we use this type of object oriented programming to secure our data. So here are some examples. Here is given that Java, C++, Smalltalk, Simula 67, etc. So let's move to another slide. Yes, so this is very important. OOPS features. What is OOPS feature? So here it is saying it gives stress on the data items rather than the function. So what a data item stored in that particular object, it gives that particular stress. Means it is focusing on data items, not the functions. I will discuss further on this video when we will go to the object topic. I will make the video. It makes the complete program or problem simpler by dividing into number of objects. So OOP is dividing the complete program into number of objects, means it creates a program and it we can accordingly we can divide number of objects. A real world, it is considering a real world. Basically it is considering number of objects that depend on ourselves, how much object we can create by a single number of program. The concept of data hiding enhances security in program. So what basically is saying that concept of data hiding, it has encapsulation abstraction features which hide the data. That are the principle of OOPS which he is given here, and it is highly beneficial to solve complex problem. Yes, because it divides the complete program into similar number of objects, so it is easily to solve complex problem because we can divide into small objects. So let's go to another. Basic element of OOP or principle of OOP. So what is given here? Object, classes, data abstraction, encapsulation, data hiding, data hiding, inheritance, polymorphism, dynamic building. These all are the basic elements. So I hope you understand what is OOP, and I will further classify of what is object, what is classes, and what are the basic principles. Thanks for watching.